Hello, welcome back to Design Patterns. In this video, I will explain the bridge pattern. The bridge pattern is about decoupling abstractions from implementations. What does this mean? For example, we as a client developer, we want to implement, let's say, a Windows application. And we want to have some graphical user interface for that. We want to use some buttons and some text boxes or some container and so on. And all these components define some abstraction layer. This is not only one class, this can be a whole layer of classes, a whole family of components. And of course, there has to be some concrete implementation for it. Think of the different graphical user interface widgets which exist for Python, for example. So here we are in user world. But all these implementations need to use some graphically basic primitives which the operating system supplies. This is a different world. So here the operating system begins. And we have some graphical primitives. We can draw pixels, we can draw lines, we can draw text, and so on. But there is no concrete notion of buttons or text boxes or even a window. So this is another world. And in addition to this, we have these basic primitives, but depending on the installed graphical libraries, for example, OpenGL or DirectX or some other graphic libraries, these can be implemented differently. For example, there could be an implementation which runs completely on the CPU, or there could be an implementation which runs on the graphics card. Our implementations can be implemented differently and can evolve independently, but the abstractions here for the user, for the client, they should stay the same. For example, we don't have a simple Windows system. Maybe we have a fancy Windows system where we have animations, or think of Linux where we have different window managers and different styles which the Windows can take on. This is the idea of the bridge pattern, to have an implementation or an abstraction layer on both sides of the system. So on the implementation side and on the abstraction side. Basically, these are adapters for both sides. And by doing it this way, both sides can evolve independently from each other. And you may ask, where is the bridge here? Here it is. What are the properties of the bridge? The context is we have an application which has separate abstraction and implementation hierarchies. The problem is now, how can we decouple the development of both hierarchies? And the forces are, we want to avoid permanent binding between abstraction and implementation. If all our Windows systems would be bound to the underlying graphics library, for example, DirectX, whenever Microsoft comes out with a new version of DirectX, all our Windows systems have to be re-implemented, which is not very useful. So both sides should be extensible by subclassing. For example, our Windows system should be extendable and our underlying graphics library should be extensible. Changes should be contained to one side. For example, if we develop a fancy animation system on our Windows side, the underlying graphics library should not have to change. And we want to hide the implementation side completely from the client. So the client doesn't have to implement DirectX matrices and pipes in order to implement a graphical system. It just wants to use buttons, text boxes, and so on. The implementation should be compatible to multiple abstractions. Especially on Linux, this is very visible. If you have different window managers, they all look differently, but use the underlying graphical primitives in the background. The solution is to create two interfaces. Firstly, the implementer interface. These are the internal primitives, the basics, and an abstraction interface, which covers the client requirements. This is actually the interface the client has to work with, therefore it should cope for the client requirements. And then we have to implement those interfaces with individual classes. Then we can implement more than just one class, we can derive from them, we can build up whole hierarchies of classes on both sides. And then, in the abstraction, we only are allowed to use the implementation interface. So we are not allowed to use the concrete implementations, just their abstract interface. And of course, the client only is allowed to use the abstraction interface. What are the consequences? We have a decoupled abstraction and implementation. We improve the extensibility. Both sides can grow independently. We hit away the implementation details from the client because he only uses the abstraction interface. The implementation can be configured at runtime. Also, at compile time, we don't have dependencies on the actual implementations anymore, but just to the interfaces, which is a good thing. It encourages layering. We have at least two layers because we have the implementation layer and we have the abstraction layer, and then there is the client layer. This is quite a benefit. One liability here is, who defines the composition? Who actually builds together all the objects for the bridge? For this, we need to use one of the creational patterns. With the flexibility of the bridge pattern also comes higher complexity. We have more classes, more interfaces, more abstraction layers in between. But the benefits of flexibility and extensibility outweigh this drawback by far. So when you think of the bridge, think of the old Packhorse Bridge in Carrbridge in Scotland. This is a photo of 2018. And this bridge is the oldest stone bridge in Scotland. And it connects the implementation with the abstraction. This bridge is located near Inverness in the north of Scotland, where also the Tomatin distillery is not far away, which is an excellent whiskey. Okay, that was the bridge pattern.